Titanium rings have been primarily constructed from titanium. The actual compositions of titanium can vary, such as commercial pure, 99.2% titanium, or aircraft grade, primarily 90% titanium, 6% aluminum, 4% vanadium. And titanium rings are often crafted in combination with other materials, such as gemstones and traditional jewelry metals. Even with these variations in composition and materials, titanium rings are commonly referred to as such if they contain any amount of titanium. Rings crafted from titanium are the modern phenomenon, becoming widely available on the market around 1990. Titanium rings offer several unique properties. They are hypoallergenic, lightweight, corrosion resistant, and have the highest strength to weight ratio of any metal. Titanium was discovered in Cromwell, England in 1791 by William Gregory, who was also discovered around the same time by Hungarian mineralogist Franz Joseph Müller von Richtstein, and later in 1795 by German chemist Martin Heinrich Klaproth, who gave titanium its name, a reference to the Titans of Greek mythology. However, it was not until 1932 that commercial use for titanium became possible, due to methods established by William Justin Prohl, who devised ways of reducing titanium tetrachloride into its metal form. His process is still used today for commercially produced titanium. The cost of titanium rings can be very high. This is because the process of extracting titanium from its various ores is laborious and costly. It is unknown who first crafted titanium into a ring or other jewelry piece. A titanium wedding ring is used as a minor plot point in the 1989 science fiction film and novel The Abyss. Titanium started appearing on the open market in approximately 1990s. Since 2000, availability of titanium rings has become large scale. Titanium rings are constructed using solid bars, tubes, or sheets of titanium, which are cut into the desired shape and size of the ring. The metal can be machined using the same equipment and via the same engineering processes as stainless steel. The usual jewelry making techniques of rolling and soldering are not practical for titanium. Titanium has become popular as a jewelry material due to its various unique properties. Titanium is hypoallergenic or non-toxic to the human body. Similarly, titanium rings will not react with wearers who suffer allergies to other jewelry materials. It is highly corrosion resistant to most causes of corrosion, including seawater, aquafina, chlorine, and some acids. It is soluble in concentrated acids. However, titanium rings are therefore practical for those who regularly swim in the ocean or chlorinated pools, for example. This is in contrast to some other traditional jewelry materials such as silver, brass, and bronze, which are prone to tarnishing and other manifestations of deterioration. Titanium rings, depending on composition, have varying degrees of fatigue resistance and tensile strength. However, almost all well-known compositions feature higher fatigue resistance as well as strength-to-weight ratios than most, if not all, known metals. It can be difficult to find someone to resize titanium rings, but it is possible to reduce and increase ring size if needed. The amount of reduction and increase is limited. They are only slightly more difficult to cut off in case of emergency than gold rings. Titanium is comparable to steel in its resistance to sawing. Anodization of titanium rings is the process whereby an oxide film is formed on the surface of the titanium via an electrolyte process to create color. In the case of titanium rings, this process is generally performed after it is machined into shape. Oxidization changes the ordinary titanium color, generally silver, depending on composition and processing, and increases corrosion resistance. The anodization process is extremely simple to carry out. A piece is immersed in an electrolyte. Cola is popularly used, and a DC voltage around 100 volts is applied. The voltage controls the thickness and lasts the color of the anodization. Dyes are not necessary in the anodization of titanium. The color that results on the titanium ring depends on the thickness of the oxide coating, which is determined by the anodizing voltage. The colors, which are simply different wavelengths of light, arise from constructive interference between the light reflected from the surface of the oxide layer and the light reflected from the metal surface below. Titanium compositions. Titanium can be alloyed with many other metals to enhance or alter titanium's properties. The most common alloy partners for titanium are aluminum, vanadium, iron, and copper. Each alter titanium's properties for various purposes. For example, copper can be used to harden titanium. One of the most common compositions for titanium rings is known as aircraft-grade titanium, because the composition is famous for its use in aircraft construction. However, it is also used for medical, marine, and chemical processing. It is a blend of 6% aluminum, 4% vanadium, 90% titanium, and is one of the strongest and most lightweight of other known compositions. Aircraft-grade titanium is often used in crafting titanium rings due to its advantageous and suitable properties compared with other titanium compositions, as well as its wide commercial availability. Inlays are a result of combining two or more metals into one ring. It is not to be confused with alloying. The process of inlaying involves crushing the metals into channels, which are then trapped under pressure on the ring. This usually results in the metals sitting side by side on the surface. For example, a strip of gold running through the middle of an otherwise titanium ring. The purpose of inlays are to enable various metals within the titanium ring to be visible and distinguishable.